So we'll be solving quant for RC12 now. So let's begin this. So for some Kamya and Ramya, so 25 questions I see. Okay, so Kamya and Ramya left from their respective homes to meet each other, unknown to the fact that the other person had also left. After reaching their destination, they came to know the other person had left them. So they crossed each other at a point 70 kilometers from Kamya's home during their first trip, and then at a point from Ramya's home, find the distance between Kamya and Ramya. So this, suppose this is K, this is Ramya. Okay, so K and M. So they began at the same time. After reaching, they came to know that the other person had, so they turned back. The time wasted is minimum. They crossed each other 70 kilometers during their first trip. Okay, so 70 kilometers from Kamya's home. Okay, so 70 kilometers from Kamya's home. This is, say, 70 kilometers. And during the return trip, and then again at a point 50 kilometers from Ramya's home during the return trip. Okay, so this is, say, 50 kilometers from, say, this point, and this was 70 kilometers from this, and this is 50 kilometers from Ramya's home while returning. Okay, so I know the distances are given, so let's take the speed ratio. The speed ratios will be equal in both the situations. So let's see. In the first case, they meet at 70 kilometers. So if the total distance, if I consider the total distance as, suppose, as D, okay, then in this case, let's take the speed of Kamya divided by Ramya. Okay, so I know the speed ratio will be equal to the speed ratio will be equal to the distance ratio, since the time is equal. So let's start this. So in the first case, Kamya travels 70 divided by Ramya travels D minus 70, right? And that is equal to, during the return journey, what I see is Ramya has traveled this distance and then this distance, that is D distance, okay, D distance and 2D minus 50 distance. Okay, so he has traveled 2D minus 50 distance, that is D. Okay, so 2D minus 50, that is what Ramya has traveled, and Kamya during the return trip has traveled D plus 50, that is, has traveled this distance D and then returns back another 50 kilometers. So D plus 50. So Kamya has traveled D plus 50 and Ramya has traveled 2D minus 50. Okay. So let's quickly solve this equation. So I have, what do I have? D square minus 70D plus 50D. Okay, D square minus 70D plus 50D minus 3500 is equal to how much? It is 140D minus 3500. So just remove this 3500. It becomes minus 20 minus 20. D square minus 160. Okay, D square minus 160. D is equal to 0 is my final equation. So D becomes equal to 160. So it is 160. Okay, so I took a lot of time in this. So moving on to the next sum. If the length of the sides of right angle triangle are this, find the area of the triangle rounded off to the nearest integer. Okay, right angle triangle, the three sides are this. So any of the sides can be the hypotenuse. I have to take three cases. 5x plus 4, 3x plus 5, then 4x plus 6. Definitely round two question. I would come to this later. If the point of tangency between the incircle of triangle and one of the sides of triangle divides into two segments of length, this, find the measure of the longest side given the in radius measures 2 cm. I think I can solve this sum, but again, time consuming, probably I'll come to this later. The highest power of 2 that divides this one should be easy. The highest power of 2 that divides 17 to the 128. Let's convert this 17 into 16 plus 1 to the power 128 minus 1. So now use binomial expansion. Let's start with the lowest powers of 2. When will be the lowest powers of 2? From the last term, like it's 128, see 128, 1 to the power 128. Okay. And the next term would be So this will get cancelled out by this minus 1. So the next term would be 128 C 127 into 16 to the power 1 into 1 to the power 127. For all the remaining terms, the power of 2 will be higher than this particular term, because then 16 will come in square, cube and everything. So this will have the lowest power of 2. And that is the highest power of 2 that will divide this entire sum. So this minus 1 and this which equates to 1, this cancels out. So the first term is this one. And I have to check the power of 2 in this. So it is 128. See, 127 is 128 into 16. So this is the first term. And this has the lowest power of 2. So this is 2 to the power 4 into 2 to the power 7. So 2 to the 11. So 11 is the highest power that 2 can divide in this equation. Okay, so moving ahead. Which of the following is the sum of all numbers less than 250 which are divisible by either 5 or 6? Okay, either 5 or 6. But not by the sum of all numbers less than 150. Okay, so if I start with 5, 10 plus 15, it becomes 5 into n in 5, 1 plus 2 plus up to 49. That is 245, right? So just use the formula n into n plus 1 by 2, where n is equal to 49. 49 into 50 is 49 into 25. I'll just use the calculator quickly so that I don't go wrong. 49 into 25 into 5, I can do 6125. This gives me 6125. Okay. Similarly for 6, what I will have is, I will have, I think, 246 would be the last term. So I have 41 terms in this. So 6 into 41 into 42 by 2, which is 26 into 41 into 6 is the sum of this. Okay, so sum of this, 6 into 41 into 26. So I have 6396. 6396. Just a second. I think I did a mistake. Sorry. This is 42. Oh, sorry. This was 21. I just multiplied by 26. So this is 6 into 41 into 21, which gives me 5166. Okay, so this gives me 5166. So I have 5166 over here. So these two will get added up. But however, I have to remove all those terms where I have added 30 as well. So I added it twice. So I have to remove it twice. Okay, so LCM of 5 and 6, that is 30. So 30 plus 60 plus these terms I have to remove, which I have added both in this calculation as well as in this calculation. Okay, in both I have included these. So 30 into this adds up till, I think, 8 times this will add up. So 8 into 9, that is 4 into 9, 36 into 30. 36 into 30, this gives me 1080. So I have to remove 1080 twice, because it is included in 5166 as well as 6125. So the final thing becomes 5166 plus 6125 minus 2 into 1080. That is the final sum. I'll just calculate this. 5166 plus 6125 plus 6125 minus twice of this, is 2160. So I just have 9131. 9131. Yes, 9131. So I'll have this as my answer. Moving ahead, find the number of digits when log 5 is equal to this. Very easy. Very easy. This one is, just I have to remember the formula. Remember the formula for this. That is, you have to take the log to find the number of digits. You have to take the log. Okay, so I just have to simplify this thing. So it n log of n. Okay, so number of digits of n would be log of n plus 1. Log of n plus 1. Okay, so n digits. So simplify, log of n is equal to 150 log 6250. Simplify this. That is 5 to the power 2, 5 to the power 3, 5 to the power 4 into 10. Okay, 5 to the power 4 into 10. It becomes, so I have 150 into log of 5 to the power 4 into 10. Let's see, 5 to the power 4 into 10. If I separate this, to 150 into 4 log 5 plus log of 10. I know log of 10 is equal to 1. This is equal to 1. So 4 log 5 value is given 0.699. So just calculate 4 into this. So 4 into 0.6990, 0.6990. So this becomes this. Just add 1 to this and multiply this by 150 and add 1 to the 569.4 I get, and plus 1, that is close to 570. So 570 will be the answer. Okay, so the formula for this is log n plus 1. Simple formula. Was asked question by a student, is there any number where the numeric value of number itself is equal to the sum of the factorial of the individual digit and that the given number must be a three-digit number? Okay, find out such. So the numeric value of number itself is equal to sum of the factorial. Okay, so I remember this is a Krishnamurti number, but I really do not know. So it's like a number like 145. Number like 145 is what they are asking for. I remember this as the Krishnamurti number. However, I am not sure about all the numbers that are there, but I'll come back to this. I'll come back to this. This is like probably round two question to find all the numbers. Let's see. The center of the two circles are equal radii. So there are two circles. They intersect at x and y. Ax, y, a centers are a and b. Radius is 8 equal for each. So a, b and ax, by is a square. Okay, ax, by is a square. You know the diagram. This is a square. This is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. Radius of each circle is this. Okay, so what I have to do is I have to calculate this shaded area. This shaded area. So it will be, I can see that it will be something like, it will be something like, if I take this area, this would be this area minus the triangle, minus this triangle. Okay, minus this triangle would give me this particular area, right? Would give me this particular area. Okay, so I'll have the purple area by subtracting the triangle area from the quarter circle. So let's do it. That is centers of two circles. The radius of either find the common area to the two circles. So radius is this. So the area of the quarter circle becomes pi r square by 4. That is pi 8 square by 4. Okay, that and the area of the triangle becomes half into 8 into 8 minus half into 8 into 8. However, the total area is twice of the purple circle, a purple shaded area, if you can see, because I have to do the same for the other side as well. So just multiply this by 2. Okay, so the final answer that I have is pi 8 square, which is 6432 pi. This is 32, sorry, this is 64 by 4, that is 16 pi minus 4 into 8, that is 32 into 2. So I have what, 32 pi minus 64. So if I take common 32, I have pi minus 2. Okay, so I have pi minus 2. So this is the answer, 32 pi minus 2. Okay, so ninth sum. Let's come to this. I have to quickly do this. Okay, so this is moving an escalator problem. Okay, so always in escalator problem, take the speed of the escalator as e steps per second, and you can solve almost everything. On with constant speed of 4 steps per second. Okay, Melina has a speed of 4 steps per second, and Donald has a speed of 0.5 steps per second. So Melina took 300 steps. So if she took 300 steps, how much time will it take for her to take for 300 steps? If she takes 4 steps per second, it will take her 75 seconds. 75 seconds to take 300 steps. And Donald takes 90 steps. 90 steps. So how much time will it take for him to take 90 steps? 90 divided by 0.5, that is 180 seconds. Okay, so Melina was on the escalator for 75 seconds. Donald was on the escalator for 180 seconds. And I know the speed of the escalator is E. So the distance that they travel will be the distance of the escalator, which is constant. Always the in escalator problem, the distance is constant. So 75 seconds the escalator travels, that is 75 E is the distance traveled by the escalator, plus 300 steps taken by Melina is equal to 180 seconds the escalator travels in case of Donald, plus 90 steps taken by Donald. This is equal. So if I just equate this, it is 105 E is equal to 210. So E becomes 2 steps per second. 2 steps per second is the speed of the escalator. How many steps if the escalator becomes stationary? So just substitute E equals to 2 and just equate in any of the equation. So 75 into 2, that is 150, plus plus 300 equals 450. That is 450 steps. Okay, so it's going from C to D and 1/3 every hour. Okay, so the speed is getting 1/3 every hour. If the train starts at the speed of 81 kilometer per hour, the distance between this is okay. So 122 is the distance. So it becomes 1/3 every hour. So C to D 81, then it becomes 27, then it becomes nines. Okay, so I know that it will follow a GP. So let's assume this to be an infinite GP and see what is the total distance traveled. Total distance traveled would be a by 1 minus r. So the common ratio is equal to 1/3. So the formula is a by 1 minus r. A is the first term for an infinite GP. So 81 divided by 1 minus 1/3, which gives me 81 by 2/3, 81 into 3 by 2. Okay, so this gives me 243 divided by 2. 243 divided by 2, it is 121.5. Okay, so if it continues till infinity, it can only travel a distance of 121.5, and the total distance is 122. So even if it continues till infinity, it is not possible. It cannot reach the destination. This is the answer. Usually, when you will have these questions, you can get the hint that it is heading towards this. It won't reach the destination. If a regular polygon has a total of 275 diagonals, exterior angle of the polygon, simple sum, just put the formula of the number of diagonals that is in a polygon, that is n into n minus 3 by 2 is equal to 275. Just quickly do this, n square minus 3n is equal to 275. 40, 550 minus 550 is equal to 0. So what I have is n square minus 25n. Okay, so 25n plus 22n minus 550 is equal to 0. So n into n minus 25 plus 22, which is n plus 22 is equal to 0. So what I have is n is equal to it cannot be minus 22, so it will be 25. Okay, so there are 25 sides in the polygon and exterior angle. The sum of the exterior angle of a polygon is 360 degree, and since it's a regular polygon, divide by the number of sides. So 360 divided by 25. 360 divided by 25. I have 14.4. 14.4. Okay, that is there. 14.4. Okay, so moving ahead. 3/5 of the voters promised to vote for P and the rest promised to vote for Q. Of these last 20% 30% sum, P and Q, two voters. 3/5 of the voters, let the total voters be 100x. 3/5 of the voters promised to vote for Q and 2/5 promised, rest promised for X, that is 40X promised for Q. Okay, so on the last 20% of the voters went back on their promise to vote for P. Okay, so out of the 60X, how many did not vote? 20X, that is 12X did not vote for P. So they went to Q. Okay, and the rest 48X voted for P. Okay, and 30% of voters went back on their promise to vote for Q. 30% of this, which means 12x voted for P and the rest 28x voted for this. Okay, so 12x did not vote for this, 12x did not vote for this. So ultimately there was no change. Again, he got 12, he got P got this 12x plus this 48x, that is again 60x, and Q got this 12x plus 28x, again 40x. So both got 60x and 40x votes at the end. And Q lost by 5,000 votes. Q lost by 5,000 votes. So you can see the difference between P and Q. The vote difference is 20x. Okay, so 20x is equal to 5,000. I can see, so x is equal to 250. So the total number of voters would be 100 into 250. That is 25,000. 25,000, right? Okay, so I have moved to the next sum. Anil wants to sell both his cars. He sells the first car at a loss of 25%. He marks the second car up by 140% and gives a discount of 45%. Okay, so this is again like purse profit and loss and discount. So he so sells the first car at a loss of 25%. So let the cost of the car be 100x. The selling price becomes 75x since it was sold at a loss of 25%. He marks second car by 140% and then gives a discount of 145%. Okay, what is the overall profit percentage and loss? What is the overall? So second car CP, do I know? No, I do not know the CP, but I know that given that the selling price of both the cars are same. Okay, so 75x was the SP for the second car as well. Let the CP for the second car be Y. He marks up by 140%, so the price becomes 2.4 Y, and gives a discount of 45%. So if I multiply 0.55, that is the SP of the car, then that is equal to 75x. Okay, so because he gives a discount of 45%, I can multiply the final price by 0.55. So now what I have, I'll just use a calculator to equate Y, how much Y is equal to this. So Y is equal to 75 divided by 2.4 divided by 0.55. So 56.81. So Y is equal to, so Y is equal to 56.81x. So that is my CP of the car, and I sold it for 75x. Okay, let's the total SP. The total SP of the two cars was 75x into 2, that is 150x, and the total CP was 100x, 100x plus 56.81x. So that is my 156.81x, 156.81. So 6.81 is the 6.81 is the loss that I do. 6.81 is the loss that I do out of 156.81. So I'll again use just the calculator to quickly calculate this. 5.61 divided by 156.81. I could have approximated, but the number seemed close. It is somewhere around. Let me wait. Like 5. I think I did a mistake here. 6.81. Sorry, that is 6.81. 6.81. 6.81 divided by 156.81. I wasted a lot of time. Should have approximated 4.34. 4.34%. That's pretty close. I don't know. Assam tea is very famous in the international market. Okay, so. And is being sold at a premium. There are other types of tea available in the market. Trader wants to earn massive profit. His selling price is fixed at this, and he wants to gain 25% on the transaction. So selling price is equal to 1500. Selling at the cost price of Assam tea. So CP of Assam tea is equal to 1500. Okay, that is 1500. And he wants to gain 20 in the transaction. Find out what kija other teas should he mix, given that the price of the other teas, 1000 other tea is equal to 1000 per kg, and he has mixed 500 gram of Assam tea. Should he mix with 500 gram of Assam tea? Okay, so let's do this. 500 into 1500 into 500 plus 1000 into x. That is x is the amount of the other tea. X, this is amount is x. So 500 plus x should give you what? Should give you a 25% profit. So the total CP should have been this divided by 1.25, which is equal to 1200. Okay, so this should be equal to 1200. This should be equal to 1200. So what I ultimately get is 500. That is equal to. So I'll just multiply this quickly. Okay, so 75,000 minus the 60,000, it is equal to 1,50,000, 1,50,000, 1,50,000. If I get 1,50,000 and x in terms of x, it is 1200x, and here it is 1000x, so 200x. Okay, so 200x is equal to 1,50,000, 1,50,000. So x is equal to 75,750, right? 750. Okay, so it is 750. Went to pick up his mom from bus station. He went at some time before between 7 and 8 and came back 8 and 9. Again, typical clock problem, very typical problem. The total rotation would be 360 degree. I know the when like you go out between 7 and 8 and come back between 8 and 9, the total distance traveled by the minute and the second hand combined is 360 degree. When he came back, he observed that the position of the hour hand and the minute hand is interchanged. Find out the time when he came back home. Okay, so this is not like typical problem. I was thinking about he would ask how much time was he outside. So find out the time he came when he came back home. So pretty it will get pretty difficult if I go to solve this. But the thing is, he left between 7 and 8, I know. And so suppose this is 8, this is 7 in a clock. So I have 7, 8, this is 9. Okay, 9. So the and he came back between 8 and 9. So the hour hand will move towards this. Okay, will move in this direction. So if I just if it will move in this direction and it is it will be somewhere over here when he comes back, right? It will be somewhere over here when he comes back. 8. So the minute hand, and I know the minute hand was and they got interchanged. So the minute hand, which was particularly in this direction, over here probably. That comes over here. That comes over here. So the minute hand after when he comes back is between 7 and 8. And the hour hand is between 8 and 9. Okay, so I know when he comes back, it will be between 8:35 to 8:40, right? So 8:35 to 8:40, I have only one option. So this will be the answer. So do not go to solve this particular sum. Just solve it this way. Okay, find out the number of two digits that said that the squares are equal to sum of the factorial of any number and any other single digit natural number. Okay, so I have to check this whether this can be done. Two digit numbers. Okay, so two digit numbers. So it is 10 to 99 are the two digit numbers. So let's the square of these are 99. What's the square for 99? 9801 is the square for 99. So 100 to 9801 will be between this and equal to sum of the factorials of any number. Okay, the factorials. Let's try for the factorials. I know 4 factorial is 24. It is not a 3-digit number. 5 factorial is 120. 6 factorial is 720. And 7 factorial is this into 0 5040. Okay, so this is 5040, right? Yes, 5040. And 8 factorial, this into 8 would be greater than 9801. If I do 8 factorial, it would be greater than 9801. So I do not take 8 factorial. I take only 5 factorial, 6 factorial and 7 factorial. Let's see. 5 factorial is 120 plus 1 will give me 11 square. 6 factorial is 720. I know. 27 square. 27 square is like 729, right? Plus 9 would give me 729. So, okay, this is also done. 6 factorial, 7 factorial. 7 factorial, is it possible? Let's see, 50 square, 60 square is 3600, 70 square is 4900. So 4900, let's try what is 71 square. 71 square since 5041. 5041 definitely works. This is plus 1, 5041, this works. So I'll have these 3, right? So yes, 3 is the answer for this. The data households taken, there were 67 households that are doing this. Okay. So I have. Okay. So 6 kids, this Venn diagram. What is the maximum percentage? Okay. So I have 3. There is kids. This is adult. This is senior citizen. I need to maximum of 3. I need to maximize this portion. If I need to maximize this portion, matlab this one and this one is minimum. Okay, let's put this. So let's put these as 0 only. 0, 0, 0. Okay, let's change the color so that it's easy to understand. 0, 0, 0. Let's put this as A, B, C, and D. So A plus B plus C plus D. Let's that be 100%. That is 100%. And A plus B plus C plus 3D is equal to 67 plus 73. That is 140. 140 plus 86. That is 226. Okay, so let's subtract these two equations. I get 2D is equal to 126, D is equal to 63. So that is when it gets maximized. It gets maximized when all the twos are zero. When all the common elements between any two are zero, it is 63%. The line passing through intersects this unit away from the origin on y-axis. Okay, so it intersects over here. So this is 0,1. This is 0,1. Okay, it intersects over here. So let's put that point. So if I put 0,1 in this equation, so what I get is D plus 1 is equal to 0. So D, I have got the value, that is minus 1. Okay, so the line passing through 5,6 intersects this line at 90 degree. So 5,6 and 5,6. So the point this line passes through 5,6 and 0,1. Okay, so the slope of this line is 6 minus 1 divided by 5 minus 0. That is equal to 1. And this, if the slope of this line is equal to 1, then I know the slope of this particular line. This particular line will be -1 since it intersects at 90 degree. M1 into M2 is equal to -1. So it is minus 1. And the slope of this line I know is equal to minus C by D. Minus C by D is equal to -1. So which means D I know is equal to -1. So C will also be equal to -1. And what is the value of C minus D? So C minus D will be equal to 1 minus 1 minus minus 1. That is 0. 0. Okay, so this is how I do this. Let's go for this. X square minus 5x. X square minus 4x minus x plus 4 is less than 0. So x minus 4 into x minus 1. Right. X minus 4 into x minus 1. Will give me less than 0. X minus 1 less than 0 gives me this. So I have this particular equation. And the next, if I equate, so I have x cube minus 6x square. 8 is 2 cube. So 8x minus 2 square, 3a square b. Yes, so the next equation is simply x minus 2 whole cube. You can see this. Okay, so if you see this, what I've got here is this particular thing. So now I have x minus 4 into this. So x should be 1, 4. It is something like this. It should be between 1 and 4. Or it should be... which of the following values x cannot take? So x, it should be greater than 2. Okay, it should be greater than 2. It should be greater than 2. And it should be greater than 2. And it can be 2 and 4. It has to be between 2 and 4. So 2.1 it can take. 3.1 it can take. 4.1 it cannot take. Right. A plane is flying at an altitude of this. Okay, so let's go for this kind of a sum. At an altitude of 3,000 feet. 3,000 feet. I'll come back to this actually. I have to draw the diagram. I'll come back to this later. If the measure of such a triangle is this, then the measure of second side is between this. Then find out the number of possible triplets so that the triangle is a right angle triangle. Round two, definitely, if I get time for this. Definitely, I have number of sums. I have to list... possibly all the triplets here are very, very hectic. Do not attempt this. I'll probably not ever come back to 22. Bus is going from Indore to Mumbai and makes 6 stops on the way. The persons enter the bus. I have to say how many different sets of tickets they have had. Okay, so there are like 6 stops on the way. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is Mumbai. So the three persons enter the bus with 3 different tickets. Okay, so different tickets. How many different sets of tickets they could have? Okay, so first try to find the total combination of tickets. Okay, so the first who enters over here, that one can purchase ticket for second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth or Mumbai. So he can purchase 6 tickets. The person who enters at point 2 can purchase tickets for 3, 4, 5, 6 and Mumbai. That is 5 tickets. Similarly, for other stations as well. So if I just add this up. 6 into this is 6 into 7 by this, it is 21. Okay, 21. So 21 tickets, different combination of tickets can be formed. And I have to choose 3 people who chose 3 different tickets from these 21 tickets. So 21C3 is the answer. 21C3 is the answer. So 21 into 20 into 19 divided by 6. So I'll just quickly do this. 7, this is 2, this is 10. So 17 into 19. 1400, it is 13. It is supposed to be 13. Sorry, this is 1970. 20, it is 1400. Oh God, why am I just wasting my time over here? 1330, right? What was I thinking? 1330. Okay, so a question paper, every right answer fetched 1.5 marks. So every wrong answer, he got this many marks. Okay, so 180 question, 1.5 marks for right answer, 3/4 mark for this, and deducted 2/5 mark is imposed. And student attempted 130 questions. Okay, so 130 was attempted, 50 was unattempted. For 150, he will lose, say 2/5 of the mark, 2/5, that is 0.4. So he loses 20 marks. Definitely, he loses 20 marks for not attempting this question. And out of 130 attempted, he will get say x correct and 130 minus x incorrect. Okay. So for 130, he will get 1.5 marks. And for every wrong answer, he will get 0.75 will be deducted out of this. So 130 minus x. So what I have over here is something like. Okay, sorry, this is x into 1.5x. X into 1.5x minus 0.75 into 130 minus x. Okay, so this becomes 0.75x. Sorry, 1.5x plus 0.75x. This becomes 2.25x. 2.25x minus 0.75 into 130. It is 7.5 into 13. 7.5 into 13. That gives me 137. 137.5 minus this 20 which I already had, so 117.5. Okay, so the final marks becomes this minus 117.5x. Okay, so now I know that this, how many distinct positive integers can you get? Okay, positive integers can you get? Okay, so I'll just simplify this quickly. Simplify this quickly. Okay, so what I had was 2.25x minus 117.5x, 117.5, sorry, 117.5. So I have to see what is the lowest value possible. So 50 becomes is not possible. I have to see the lowest value. So 50, 117 by this, and it becomes 54 into 25x. Yes, so it becomes something like, is it possible at 52? 52 into 2.25. It is less than 100 this. Okay, so 54, it starts with 54. It starts with 54. So definitely at 56, it will not be an integer. At 58, again, it will be an integer. At 62, it will be an integer. So let's keep on till 130. This becomes 130 minus 54. That is divide by 4 plus 1 is my answer, which becomes 6, 60, 76 by 4 plus 1. That is 19 plus 1, 20. 20 is the answer. Okay, so I think there's a class of in the unit test, if the probability of worst tangamang is expressed as p by q. Okay, so p by q. Okay, so this is the worst rank can be 9. So 9C7. 9C7. So all the girls have to be within 9C7 minus those cases where the worst rank is 8 or the worst rank is 7. Okay, 9C7 gives me all those possible situations where the worst rank of a girl is either 7 or 8 or 9. Okay, so I have to subtract all those equations, those where the worst rank is 7 or 8, because I need the worst rank exactly at 9. So 9C7 minus 8C7. 8C7 includes both where the worst rank is 8 and 7. So this 9C7 minus 8C7 should give me how much? 9 into 8, 9 into 8 divided by this. Okay. So 2, it is 4, 36 minus, so it is 36 minus 8C7, which is 8 divided by 1 factorial, that is 8, 28. I am not sure of the calculation. I have to move fast now. Find out the number of power of 5 in this. Very easy. 250 factorial divided by 5, it is 50 divided by 5 again, 10, it is again divided by 5, it is 2. So 50 plus 10 plus 2 is the highest power of 5 in 250 factorial. Okay, so 50 plus 10 plus 2 is 62. Okay, 62. Okay, so I can submit the test. I have to move to one of the plane is flying. This one was there. This is not, I'm not doing this. This is not doing this as I don't know if 145 exists. I don't know any other number. This I'm not sure about this till now. This, if I can quickly solve this, I'll try it. 3000 feet, depression angle is 30 degree, and this is top of the tower. This is 60 degree. This is 3000. So what I know is tan 60. This will be 3000 by root 3. This is because this is 60 degree. So I know this is 3000 by root 3. I take this as y. This is equal to 3000 minus y. So let's do this. One sine, that is tan 30. Tan 30 is equal to 1 by root 3 is equal to y divide by 3000 by root 3. So this gives me how much? Y is equal to 1000. Y is equal to 1000. So the height of the tower is 3000 minus 3000 minus 1000. That is 2000. Yes, 2000. So this I have. Probably I will not be able to solve anymore. So this was RC 12 from my end.
Oh my.
So thank you, everyone.